friends. If this is your first time on my channel, you're most definitely welcome. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for sticking with your girl. If you're not, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Give this video a thumbs up because it really, really helps me out when you do. And please, please watch this video to the end. Thank you also for your patience. I've been very inconsistent lately, just a lot going on. So just continue to pray for me and pray that God gives me the strength to do what I love, and that's making videos for you guys. This is a highly requested video and something I've been getting a lot of questions about, so I was like, okay, I need to do this video sooner rather than later before like everyone's like, where's the video. So today I'm going to be talking about how to make a school list for applying to medical school. A lot of people were curious at the schools that I applied to. I've definitely mentioned how your school selection does play a huge role in your success and application process, so that's just something I want to talk about, walk you through my process, and give you some advice on how to create a school list for yourself. Let's get into the video. So as I said before, the kind of schools you apply to will determine your success and application process. Like, you can't have someone with a 3.1 499 MCAT score applying to a top 20 medical school, or someone with little to no research applying to one of the most research intensive medical schools in the US, right? So you really want to be strategic about picking schools for yourself and making sure you are applying to schools that you would be happy at. I'm going to talk a bit more about that and go into depth about the different things to consider. So the first thing that you need to do is you need to calculate your GPA. You need to know your stats, you need to know your numbers. You cannot just be randomly picking schools without knowing where you stand as a candidate. So I strongly encourage you to calculate your cumulative GPA, your science GPA, and your non-science GPA. And for those who don't know, when you apply to medical school through the AMCAS, they will recalculate your GPA, because you have to imagine there are people who are coming from different grading systems that are all applying to medical school. So how do the medical schools know that the GPA means the same thing? So the best way for that to happen is for the AMCAS to standardize the GPAs. So your GPA on your medical school application may differ a little bit than the GPA you see on your transcript. So it's important to calculate your GPA in the way that AMCAS would. And I have an AMCAS GPA calculator that I used that was given to me by a current med student that I used to kind of calculate my GPA and watch my trends. And if that's something you're interested in, go ahead and DM me on Instagram. My Instagram name is going to be up above. So just go ahead and DM me if you want that GPA calculator. So you want to calculate your GPA so you actually know, what are my numbers looking like? So for me, when I started like picking school lists, I already knew my GPA was going to be 3.25, 3.26. I knew my science GPA was around a 3.1, and I knew my non-science GPA was a 3 point something. I don't remember off the top of my head right now. So those were the numbers I was working off with. And I made a school list before I had a real MCAT score. I had used my most recent practice exams to kind of tell myself, this is probably where I'm going to be scoring around, right? I had received a 507 on one of my AMC practice exams and a 510 on another. So I knew between 507, 510 is what I was going to get on the real exam. So I used those numbers as a starting point for myself. And the reason I say knowing your GPA matters is because for me, because I knew I had really low, I had lower stats than average, I was really looking at schools that accepted students with low stats. Like, I was really paying attention to, has this MCAT score been accepted in the past before? Has this GPA been accepted in the past before? So I would look at the 10th percentile, which is like the lowest scores and GPA the school has accepted in the past, to kind of say, am I competitive for the school? Do I really have a chance? Will they actually take my application seriously? So that's kind of where my starting point was. I started with stats just because stats are important. We can't negate that. And it's important to make sure you're applying to schools that would accept what you have, you know. The next thing I would recommend is you want to write out everything you want in a medical school. It's super, super important. I didn't do this as much, and I really wish I did, because I think it would have changed some of the schools I applied to and some of the schools I'm considering. You definitely want to write out deal breakers. Like, if this school does not have X, like, you cannot go here. And if the school doesn't have a certain thing you're looking for, you shouldn't even apply, right? So writing that down and having a visualization of the things you want in a medical school will really, really help when you're picking a school or you're picking multiple schools to apply to. And it kind of already gives you a template or a prototype of the kind of medical school you want already. So that way, when you're starting to look at actual real schools, you're kind of like, this school does not look like it's fitting in with what I have right here. It's kind of like when they say, write out all the qualities you want in a man, you know, as like, you know, kind of like, this is what I want. I'm not going to settle for less. The same thing applies with applying to medical school, right? You don't want to settle for less. So you want to make sure that the schools you're applying to have everything you need to succeed. So I mentioned this before, but I would encourage you guys to use the MSAR. That's really what I used as a huge help in terms of deciding where I was applying to, because I had all this data, and it's by subscription only. I think it's like $30 for a 2-year subscription or something like that. And basically I would use that to look up the different schools. So some information you want to look out for when going on MSTAR looking at schools is you want to evaluate the cost of the medical school. Medical school is very expensive, and this is something I wish I paid more attention to in the schools I applied to. I applied to a lot of expensive schools, mostly private schools, and now I'm like, wow, this is really expensive. So you want to look at the cost. Public institutions are always going to be cheaper than private for the most part. Your state school, chances are, will probably be cheapest for you if you're a resident of that state. You want to look at their 10th to 90th percentile, meaning the lowest MCAT and GPA they've accepted in the past versus the highest and like the range. And there's a nice little tool in there where you can put in your GPA, you can put in your MCAT score, and it'll map you as a data point on the school's data. So that way you can see, do I fall out of what they've accepted in the past? Do I fall in it? Am I on the lower end? Am I on the higher end? And that's really, really helpful for you to kind of see statistically speaking where you stand with your like numbers. You also, I mean, this is gonna be different for different people, but for me what was important is looking at the percentage of black students they had. I went to predominantly white institutions, so it's not a new concept to me, it's not something new, but I did want to make sure I was applying to medical schools that did like black people, that did have a decent amount of community of color. You know, that was something that was really, really important to me going through medical school. I wanted to go through it with black people that look like me, or at least have that group of people that I can, you know, hang to. So it's really important for me to look at the percentage of students of color they have accepted. So that's something else you could look at. You want to look at, and this is all on MSTAR, you want to look at if they accept online college credit, if they accept community college credit. Not all medical schools do, and I don't think that's something people are aware of, that not all schools accept community college credit. So you want to make sure that the schools you are applying to will accept whatever college credit you have. Some medical schools will accept AP credit and some will not. And for me, that was kind of important because I got AP credit on my college transcript for calculus, so I never took calculus in college, which for some medical schools is a required class, and I needed to make sure that the schools I was applying to, if it didn't matter, that they would accept my 10 units of calculus credit I got from my AP exam. So that's something else to look at. You also want to look at the mission of the school. That's super, super important. You want to also look at percentage of what students do. So like, it'll tell you, oh, 95% of students that got in this year did research, or 50% of students that got in this year had clinical experience, or like 100% of students had shadowing experience, right? And what that data tells you is the percentage of students that they're accepting with a certain kind of extracurricular experience, which is important, right? Because if you see that a school has almost 100% of students coming in with clinical experience, chances are that's something they value in a student, right? And if you have no clinical experience, one, you should not be applying to medical school, but two, you should not be applying to medical schools that heavily focus on clinical experience, or that's something that they really value in applicants. So that's really, really important. So those are the things to look for on the MSTAR that kind of helped inform my decision. It gave me a little bit more about the school, and they just have a lot of information there. They have the cost, they tell you how much the secondary cost, which is very, very important. You want to know how much you're going to spend on applying to this school. They give you a diversity contact. It's a pretty comprehensive, it's probably money worth spending, to be honest with you. So the last thing I want to talk about is questions to ask yourself, or questions to ask while you are looking through schools. First thing is, you want to look at their mission and values. You want to ask yourself, did this school's mission and values align with my own? You know, you don't want to apply to a school that isn't focused or doesn't care about the things you care about, right? Like if you care about community health, if you care about serving the underserved, why would you go to a medical school that technically doesn't care about that, or that's not in their mission, or that's not the forefront of what they do, right? Like, you want to make sure that the mission that you see on the school match, right? And something I'm going to talk about in a different video is medical schools are looking for students who are mission fit with them. So you also want to do the same thing for medical schools too. You want to apply to medical schools that are mission fit for you. Like, what is your mission, right? For example, for me, I know as an attending, I want to serve a population of color. I want to work in the underserved where people don't have access to mental health care, you know? So that's kind of, for me, that's something important. So of course, I want to go to schools that care about social determinants of health. I want to go to medical schools that care about serving the underserved. I want to go to medical school that actually does serve the underserved, right? right? So you also want to look at the hospitals that are affiliated with the medical school. For me, one thing that was important for me was for a medical school to have an affiliated hospital where they are serving people of color, right? And you'll find that in more urban locations as opposed to rural locations, right? So those are the kind of things you want to look for. You want to look to see if the school's research intensive. If you're someone who's really, really interested in research and you want to have a lot of research opportunities, you probably want to apply to schools that have strong research opportunities, right? Not every medical school has research opportunities, and that's something you need to know. Most medical schools do require their med students to do some kind of research project or some kind of capstone project, but not all medical schools have access to like their own research. And I know a couple medical schools off the top of my head that do not do their own research, that if a student wants to do research, they have to work with another institution to do that. So that's something to consider. You also want to ask yourself, what does the curriculum look like? And that's something I didn't know to look forward to until like after I started interviewing for schools and like I was talking to med students, and like something that was pretty big is what kind of curriculum is it? Is it an organ-based curriculum or system-based curriculum? And I still gotta learn this, so shame on me for not knowing, but apparently I think a system-based is better. You also want to look at the student-teacher ratios. You want to look at student-cadaver ratios, right? Because part of your learning in medical school is anatomy, and you'll be working with a cadaver. And if a school has 20 students to one cadaver, what that tells me is that you may not get as much personal one-on-one time with the cadaver to learn the anatomy or learn the structures, right? You probably will, but like imagine having 20 students all learning from one body as opposed to school where the ratio is 5-1, where it's a group of 5 students working with the same body. That may be important, especially if you are going into a surgical field. You definitely want a lot more one-on-one time with the cadaver so you can learn the anatomy and learn everything you need to learn, you know? And that's something I didn't know to look for until my students told me to look for that, and I was like, oh, okay. So now that I know, I'm gonna tell you guys. You also want to know if it's pass or fail. Like, the pre-med process is so cutthroat, and like there's so much like stigma, there's so much pressure revolving doing well in school and getting the highest grade, and you want to release some of that pressure off of yourself when you go to medical school. Most medical schools are pass fail. There are a couple that are still letter grades, such as Morehouse College of Medicine. It still gives letter grades in their med school, so that's something to consider. Do you want to go to school where you will get a letter grade, or are you just gonna be pass fail and ain't nobody gotta know what your grade was, you know? That's something to consider. So for me, I really only wanted to go to pass fail schools because I'm just like, I don't need that kind of stress in my life to be thinking about any more grades. You want to look to see if classes are mandatory or they're recorded. Like, these are things you want to look for, right? Because the goal is you don't want to apply to schools that you may not be happy going to, because you can find yourself in a situation where you get into medical school, you come to find out you actually don't really like the medical school, but like that might be your only option, and it's like you don't want to go to medical school where you're not gonna be happy. So just do the work now. Another thing you want to consider is, do they have a strong program in whatever it is you're interested in, right? So if you know you're interested in psychiatry, such as me, you want to look for schools that have a strong psychiatry program or department, because you want to make sure you're getting the best experience you can in the specialty that you've chosen, so that way it helps you when you're applying for residency programs, right? You don't want to go to medical school that doesn't have a psychiatry department, because it just doesn't make sense. Another thing to look for is match rates. So for those who don't know, before you graduate medical school, you apply for residency, which is like your first job as a doctor outside of medical school. And residency is very, very competitive, and you want to look to see, are these medical schools able to get their students jobs? Like, are these students getting their first jobs out of medical school? And if a match rate is low, that tells you that the school is not doing a good job of getting their students into residency positions. You wanna look at STEP scores, which actually does not matter anymore, because they've officially announced that they're moving step one scores from a numerical value to pass fail. But you still want to look to see, are the students who go to the school, are they performing well on their step exams? Like, which is so important, because that tells you how well the school is preparing you for these boards and these exams, which you can't fully put on the school. The part of it is you also have to self-study and make sure you're doing what you're supposed to do, but you want to make sure you're getting a good education to set you up for success on these exams. And of course you want to look at location. You want to ask yourself, am I going to be happy in this location? I think something I wish I paid a bit more attention to with some of the schools I applied to was location and where they're located and the patient population they're serving. Like, there were some schools I applied to where they're just kind of like, let's just say I was surprised when I got to the interview and I was like, oh, I did not know your school was like this. Okay. So you want to, you know, definitely look into location. You want to make sure you're going to be in a place that will help you thrive. So if you want to be near family, of course, you probably want to look at medical schools closer to family, if you know that you can't handle four different seasons and you just want to be in the sun all day, every day, maybe the West Coast is, you know, the place for you. You really want to look at all these kind of stuff and take all of this into consideration when coming up with schools. It's super, super important. I hope this video was helpful in giving you things to think about when making your school list. Please be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. It really helps me out when you guys engage, when you guys comment, when you guys, you know, share this video with someone else. It really, really helps me out. So I will see you guys in another video. Thank you so much for watching.